Of all the Scottsboro defendants, only Clarence Norris made a life for himself in the North. He broke parole in 1946 and fled Alabama, making his way to New York. Assuming his brother's name, he got a job as a sanitation worker, married twice, raised a family, and began a fight to get a full pardon from the state of Alabama.
He wanted the world to know that he was an innocent man. He had a responsibility now to make sure that the world understood that those nine defendants in 1931 were innocent, and that it was racism, only racism, that in fact forced them to spend all those years in prison.
On an October day in 1976, Norris received word that Governor George Wallace had pardoned him.
Clarence Norris flies to Alabama, goes and meets the members of the Pardon and Parole Board, and there goes into George Wallace's office, and George Wallace, the great defender of the racial status quo in the South, signs a pardon, saying, "We were wrong. Alabama made a mistake in the 1930s, and Clarence Norris never raped anybody. The Scottsboro defendants never raped anybody."
Mr. Norris, this is your pardon, full pardon.
He was very emotional when he received the pardon at the press conference, because he remembered getting off that train with those other eight guys, and here he was getting his pardon. He's alone, and I'm sure he could feel them around him. I'm sure he could feel their presence, and he thought about them. Why me?
I have no hate, prejudice against them, creed or color. I like all people, and I think all people accused of things which they didn't commit should be free. I wish these other eight boys were around.